Hello, I will show you how to clean your computer after it's infected by the Huler virus. I put some of the code and the intro to this video in my blog, in this URL address right here. There. So I will just read it quickly. The old tablets that my scholars use, which you can now buy on eBay for $50, were infected by a virus that creates easy files for its directory. It uses the directory name as the base name. There's actually two viruses I'm trying to clean. First is the Huler virus that creates the exe in the same directory, and a mutation of the Huler virus that creates the exe inside that directory. This is much trickier to remove, as you will see later on, because it involves grabbing the lead directory and appending it to the end of the path. So there's two main things we have to do here. First is to remove the virus. I looked over the internet and found the only way to remove the virus is to completely reinstall the OS. Luckily, my disaster recovery method makes it easy, fast and easy to refresh the laptops to fresh and pristine installation. I documented my technique in this blog article. Right here. And this is the URL address. So this is a big deal for me because the laptops my scholars use has to be a mirror of my own personal laptop, with its many additional tedious setups to support my geeky needs. So if something happens to my laptop, I won't have any downtime. But for most of you who just needs internet access, reinstalling the OS is probably good enough. The second is to remove the exe files from your data directories. I can't find any tool that does this, and you will need some scripting knowledge here, so I would feel sorry for those who got infected by this virus and the lots of important data. You will also need Unix tools installed like Sigwin. It's free. I created the video so I can also demo the fun and magic scripting. So let me start. Okay, so let's start scripting. First, I will fix the file permissions that the virus altered to make the directories hidden. So this can take an hour depending on the size of the file system. So I already did it beforehand, and I'm just gonna type it again here, then cancel for demo purposes. So I'm just gonna cancel. Next, I'm gonna list all the directories and then dump it to a file. Call it dirs.net. Just ignore that. Then I made a Perl script to inspect each directory for the malicious exe files. If they exist. So let's call it temp.pl. So let's sanitize the input lines to remove the carriage return and new lines. So then let's split the directories into an array and put them in an array. So let's call it dirs. So for the first form, let's call it exe1. It's pretty straightforward. Just the entire path, and then you add exe. So let's put a command to print, to list it or to display it. Print your exe1 if it exists. And for the second form, it's trickier because you have to grab the leaf directory, which fortunately we can easily do in Perl using the -1 index. So it's dirs -1, and then we put the exe. And in the same way, we print the lazy bit type again, so I'm just going to search and replace. See how quick that is. Now, I like to do it step by step, so let me deal with the first one first. So I already cleaned out the first form before, but I'm still gonna run it here just for completeness sake. But to know that it actually catches a file if it exists. Let's create a dummy file, cd my, let's, okay, let's cd music, okay, let's say 80s, okay, patch 80s.exe. So let's run the script that here's the temp for temp.pl. Oh, look, there's other exes. Those are actually legitimate exes. So to verify, we can just do a long listen and look at the dates and the file sizes, because the Huler virus creates the exe files is all the same size, the same date. It follows a pattern. So let's double check to make sure. One way we can do here is, I don't want to use the system commands as I per, because it's very flaky in Windows. So let me use the bat, more native batch script, bat file. And I'll just use VI magic to do it. So let's call it exes.bat. Let's put quotes because there's spaces in the directory names and those will go crazy and confused. So, and then WhatsApp, ato yung ibuhat. And then WhatsApp, lagi ang tanghanilon sa gamita. And then okay, we can run it. See? It's magic. And you can see it's different sizes, it's different dates, so those are legit. So just to be clean, let's remove the dummy file we created. cd9c80s.exe. Now we will deal with the second form. So we just comment the first form, then uncomment the second form. And the same, we will need to retype there. Okay. So let's look at the thing. Wow, look at, there's like 856 lines, that's a lot, so we really need scripting here. So first we wanna make sure we don't delete legitimate exe files. So let's do a list, long list again. Append it to a, dump it to a file. Let's call it ls-l.bat, in case you wanna create, make it into a bat file later. There, see, it's amazing. So let's run it. This could take long. Let's just wait. You could actually see my personal files here. Hope there's nothing that you should not be seeing. All my secrets revealed. Jovelin. Who's Jovelin? Search Facebook. O'Reilly, that's my idol, Bill O'Reilly. No, that's the publisher, O'Reilly and Associates. I'm not the right-wing racist. Oh, look, I go to Russia. I go to Hudson Beach. Oh, the pictures. Oh, look. Oh, I went to Egypt. Oh, what was I doing there? Training to be a... Terrorist? No. I was just vacation in there. Anyway. Okay, so now let's look at and look at the pattern. See, the same, usually the same size, same date, except for a few. Like this one is different. So what do? We simply grep. So the pattern would be let's use 42065. That's, see, look at that. That's impossible that many programs will have the same size, right? Of course, that's impossible. So it can't be that coincidence. So we're sure that that's the virus file. So 42065, let's grep it. Grep 42065 lsttest.lcat to lsttest.lcat10. So let's verify, let's grep. So now all there is left to do is delete it. Let's just remove all the long listing information so we could delete up to this point. Let's say 2014. Let's start 2014 space dot then forward slash and then let's replace the forward slash there. So now we just have to prepend, remove that dash f closing quotes. You can save it as remove exes that and we can just run it. You could actually see all my pictures. You could see I do Rails scripting, Heroku. Okay, so now let's verify it to make sure it really got deleted. So that here's okay. So there's still exe remaining, but those could be the legitimate ones. Let's verify, just to double check. None of it has that 42065 size. Oh. I got scared. I thought there was few files with the same size, which means it could be another virus like this one. Spawn ints 2 3 1 4 5 6 2 3 1 4. Oh, but they're the same. Okay, they're the same size, but they're the same file. Oh, it's from system. Stupid. You know, I back up my system, so of course there's gonna be duplicate files. Oh, scared me there. So far looks good. Looks good, looks good. Okay, that's it. Thanks for watching.